guys, welcome to this vlog. This video is about ways to speak English confidently, and I'm going to talk about things you can do in your life to improve your spoken English. Let's go. Thing number one is practicing stories instead of practicing words. Like, imagine a real life situation when somebody asks you what you do for work, and instead of learning, I run my own company, learn to tell a story. So my story is, I started my company back in 2011, I was still in the university, and I was so passionate about learning languages, and I realized that the only good way to learn a foreign language is to travel somewhere. So this is the story. Practice those solid stories, and the next time you get asked some question, and there are so many questions that you get asked hundreds of times in your life, like, what do you do? Where are you from? What is this particular thing about the country where you're from? Or why are you in the United States? Or why are you anywhere in the world? Create a list of those stories, create a list of 10 stories, and practice them in the next 2 weeks, and you will be amazed how the next time when you meet a native speaker or when you start a conversation in English, you will be amazed how cool you are. By the way, in my school back in Russia, we used to practice a lot of so-called topics. We had a variety of topics like the history of the United States, my pet, my hobby, whatever, like everything. Method number two is try and sing along with your favorite singer. Try to sing in English, and the toughest songs in the world are rap songs. And let's see, I actually have some guys back in my apartment. They're practicing English. They're my friends. Oh, this is so hilarious. I've done that myself as well. Let's see how they practice Eminem.
One opportunity to sing everything you. One moment. Would they capture? Or just let it slip. His palms are sweaty, knees. That's it! my spaghetti, I'm nervous. Surface, he looks calm and ready to drop off. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote. Oh my god! Everybody's joking out, the clock's time's up, over, blow! Snap! Back to reality! Oh, there goes gravity!
That was awesome.
His palms are sweaty, knees weak, arms are heavy. His mom made all his sweater already, mom's spaghetti. He's nervous, but in the service he looks calm and ready. But he keeps on forgetting what he wrote down. He wrote so hard.
Uploaded to like Facebook with like saying white girl raps.
Why is it slower? No, it's slower.
It's not.
No, you faked it. No way. You just memorized the lyrics.
I did.
That's what you're doing there.
Or one opportunity.
Or
one opportunity.
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 Close.
Or one opportunity.
Yeah, opportunity.
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 Yo. Palms are sweet, knees weak, arms are heavy. There's vomit on his hair, mom's spaghetti, he's nervous. But looks palms are not again so fast.
And this is exactly what you should do. Switch on your favorite song, switch it on with subtitles, lyrics, and try to sing along. Try several times. Switch it on in your car when you're going somewhere and practice and practice and practice. Because you're not only practicing words, you're also practicing the manner, you're also practicing really fast talking. Because, well, rap songs are amazing, but they're so fast. But if rap song is a little too tough for you right now, you can go with any pop song, anything, you know, My Heart is in Havana, for example. I love that song, it's everywhere.
He took me back to East Atlanta, nah, nah, nah.
In any Uber that you drive around LA, you can practice it anytime. Another great thing to learn English is through a subject that interests you the most. In my case, filmmaking. I've recently discovered this platform called Skillshare. They have more than 17,000 different courses in anything. So I'm now taking filmmaking. The next would be photography because Instagram is booming. There are amazing tutorials from different people. And then the third would be singing. You know, I'm so passionate about singing. But the thing is, I'm doing that all in English because I want to practice and I want to learn terms and definitions in English so they can sit in my brain. And the next time I'm in Hollywood filming something, I can use those terms. There will be a link below. Check it out. out. I think it's an amazing deal. If you subscribe for a year, you pay less than $10 a month. And you're doing an amazing thing for your language and for your brain. Study in English and read in English and watch TV shows in English. Like, do everything in English. I'm going to ask Vinya, and Vinya is a teacher at Columbia West College here in Hollywood.
Yes, I am. There.
Okay.
I think it's very important that you take every opportunity you can to speak English, no matter where you are, if you're back in your home country or if you do come out to LA or any other city or country where they speak English. Take every opportunity you can. Don't get complacent and don't settle, because a lot of people, when they come, especially here in LA, there are so many different groups of people that kind of stick together and speak their own language and sort of like live life on their own. Don't be one of those people and actually...
Says Vinya, who's Russian, who's sitting with all the Russians here.
Don't be like me or any of us, and just really get out of your comfort zone and take every opportunity you can to...
We hate you! You think we're not your comfort zone?
Yeah, I think it's important, even in your home country. What I did in my home country, I chased foreigners in museums. So I went to like the biggest museum in St. Petersburg, the Hermitage. And I just went there and I looked for lost foreigners and asked whether they needed help, because I knew that not a lot of Russians can speak English and I could be helpful. Another advice from you guys here from the Hollywood Hills is, when you encounter a new word in English, what you do is not translate it into your own language, but you ask Siri or Alexa, your virtual helper, for a definition. And you will be listening to the definition, you will be practicing your listening skills, and you will be learning a new word, and then you repeat it. So go away from basic, go away from regular and usual. Be innovative. Use this innovative methods to practice, really go out there and practice your English. Very important advice if you want to speak English fluently is learn a lot of synonyms to words they use frequently. For example, don't say good 10 times during your speech. Learn the synonyms. Okay guys, I need 5 synonyms to good from you.
Suitable, fine, appropriate.
Can you say awesome as well? Because it's a good day, you can say it's an awesome day. It's a beautiful day.
Awesome is good.
Yeah, it's a higher degree.
It's a little better. It's a higher degree.
Depending on what you're talking about, yeah?
I mean, yeah.
So we have beautiful, we have suitable, we have...
Appropriate.
Fine.
Sound.
Okay, write those words
sound?
Down. Yeah.
As an adjective. Sound.
Wow, I didn't know that.
Solid.
Solid is another one. What you need to do is you need to start your YouTube channel. You don't have to show it to anyone. Just keep it to yourself. Record yourself, talk about anything in the world, and then listen to your speech, and then write down the words that you hear, that you pronounce all the time, and come up with synonyms. And this way you will make your speech more interesting and more diversified. This is so America. Shopping mall. Okay, she sells seashells by the seashore. I saw a kitten eating chicken in the kitchen. I thought of thanking you. Slim slam slap. A big black bug snoozed on a big black rug. He threw 3 free throws. Thin sticks, thick bricks. Fred fed Ted bread and Ted fed Fred bread. Practice tongue twisters. It helps. Another thing I noticed is that not a lot of foreigners who speak English as their second language, they don't really use tech questions. But by using them, you can actually sound more natural, more like a native speaker. So try that, like when you're talking to yourself, test that. And then practice, then go out there and practice with a native speaker using a tech question. Another thing, a very important thing, and I have a couple of friends who are struggling with English right now, and I see them doing that a lot. Please don't do it. And the thing they do is that they try to answer the question for the person. And let me stage that for you. So for example, you come into a restaurant and you ask, can I pay by cash? And because you think people didn't get you, you start, I have this credit card, can I actually use this credit card instead of cash? And because you're not maybe proficient, well, they're not really proficient in English, they confuse native speakers even more. And And America is about being simple. Americans don't like to listen to a big speech if it could be just in one sentence. Like if you compare American emails to British emails, American emails would be really short. So America is about contractions. It's about making things easier. So when you're asking a question, and I think this applies to your language as well, don't try to answer it for a person. Just ask a simple question. Do you accept cash? That's it. Don't try to, you know, go around and say, I have this plastic card, and if you swipe it, then you receive this money. This only confuses. But I know where this is coming from. This is coming from being unconfident about what you said. Just be confident, because if they didn't get it, they will just ask you again, like, what did you mean? And you will then go and explain. And if they ask you, what did you mean? You will then go and explain. And if they didn't get what you mean, they would go ahead and ask you and you will then explain. But normally, like for example, when you're ordering coffee in Starbucks, that person behind the counter doesn't really want to listen to all of that speech. Well, they're very, very nice people, but try to make things simpler. Okay, I think those were the tips that I wanted to share with you. My question to you would be, what do you think is the best place in your city or in your country, or what is this tool that you're using to communicate with native speakers? How do you do that? Where you find them? Do you go to a museum like I? But when I used to live in Russia, as I said, museums, maybe like speaking clubs. I'm waiting for your replies and your comments below, because there's so many people who are lost and who are looking for ways to communicate with native speakers. My suggestion would be going to an English speaking country and talking to natives, or going to Skillshare and trying to learn something that you love in English. I'm waiting for your comments. If you guys enjoyed watching this video, please like it and we'll see how many likes we can score. If we score 5,000 likes, then I will continue this topic and I will share more methods that I use to be more confident in my English. Thank you so much for watching this up to the end. There is a subscribe button. Never forget, always subscribe. And I'll see you in the next vlogs. Bye.